For example 8 in page number 106, in this figure, here the angle, triangle ABC, the angles are X, Y, Z. We know sum of the angles 180 degree in a triangle, so X plus Y plus Z equal to 180 degree, you know one result. And in this triangle BOC, this BOC plus this angle plus this angle equal to 180 degree. So we can equate it or substitute it. And another property, you know, it is a straight line and a ray stands on it, means sum of the adjacent angle equal to 180 degree. So using all these concepts, we are doing this problem. So the sides AB and AC are, and one more thing, exterior angle equal to sum of the interior angle. So let us see. So the sides AB and AC are produced to E and D. The sides AB produced to E and the side AC produced to D. Then another one, the angle bisectors of CBE and BCD meet at O. This is the angle bisector and this is the angle bisector. They meet at the point O. And you have to prove angle BOC, that is this angle. This angle is equal to 90 minus angle BAC. This we want to prove. Is it matter? So this question we proved in this way. That is AE. AE is a straight line and BC is a ray. Already this is Y. So definitely this will be 180 minus Y. So if a ray stands on a straight line, sum of the angle 180 degree. So if it is Y, this is 180 minus Y. So you write the same property. AB, C is a straight line. So just directly we write sum of the angle equal to 180 degree. Therefore Y plus angle which one? CBE, isn't it? CBE equal to 180 degree. Therefore CBE equal to 180 minus Y. CBE equal to 180 minus Y. So if we need CBO, we need this only because we want to take this triangle. So when you take this triangle, we need these three angles. So CBE equal to this 180 minus Y. Therefore CBO equal to 1/2 of this, because this is angle bisector, 180 minus Y, since angle bisector. So we just write similarly. So similarly, angle that side BCO equal to 1/2 of, directly we write 180 minus Z. No need to write the full step again. That side means you are taking the straight line AD, sum of the adjacent angle 180 degree. So Z, this is 180 minus Z. No need to write directly, you write similarly this one. Now consider the triangle BOC. So in triangle BOC, write the three angles BOC, then OBC, then OCB equal to 180. Sum of the angle sum property. Here you write angle sum property. Then this only we want to find BOC plus OBC. This one. Here you write 90 minus Y by 2. Here this is 90 minus Z by 2. So 90 minus Y by 2 plus 90 minus Z by 2 equal to 180. 90 plus 90, 180. This side also 180. So write BOC equal to minus, you take that side, this will be plus. So that is half of y plus z. And you consider that another, you consider another triangle. Consider the triangle ABC. In this, sum of the three angles 180 degree, that is x plus y plus z equal to 180 degree. Here y plus z we need, isn't it? Therefore y plus z equal to 180 minus x. You substitute here, mark it as 1. So here you write from 1, angle BOC equal to half of y plus z equal to half of, instead of y plus z you write 180 minus x. So this is equal to 90 minus x by 2, isn't it? This is nothing but x by 2 is nothing but BAC, not that way, minus x by 2. No need. This, okay, you can write it as 90 minus half of, what is x? X is nothing but angle BAC. So that's all. X by 2 you write half of, x is what? BAC. So up to this it is over. So in this problem, we have used sum of the three angles 180 degree, and for angle bisector means these two angles are equal.